John and Gordy Show. We're at 92.7 FM if you're still trying to find it on your radio dial.
Here we are.
And AM 1580. Good luck trying to find it this early in the morning.
Mm-hmm. It's raining outside. The rain has been continuing all night long and coming down pretty good at the moment around our area. So watch out for that this morning.
Well, I should have. I go straight down University Avenue from the west side.
Yeah.
And there is a large lake at around the UW Credit Union area where there is always a large lake when it rains heavily.
Is that near Midvale?
East of Midvale mm-hmm. Boulevard.
Yep. Yeah.
And I hit that, and we all hit it. And the person in front of me never recovered.
Really? Is that sad?
They just looked kind of like were stunned, and then they finally turned left near the hospital. But, I thought, God, recover from that, folks. Please, take it easy.
Be aware. It could be a little bit of localized flash flooding this morning.
Hey, there you go.
Yeah, that's what it is.
It's the weather lingo, isn't it?
That's it. Yeah, so be extra careful this morning.
Yeah.
It's 49 degrees. It's going to get colder through the day and about 39 by late this afternoon. And rain pretty much through the day off and on. And then gets windy and cold tonight.
No, really?
Yeah, windy and colder.
Well, what is it going to be like tomorrow? Do you know what it is?
Well, upper 30s, mid to upper 30s.
Yeah, that's not good.
Yeah, winter is not quite done with it yet. So,
all right. Well, a big news story this morning, and everybody's going to be waking up to this. The Baltimore Key Bridge collapsed because a large ship ran into one of the
bridge abutments. Yeah.
And it did. And they have video of the bridge collapsing, of the ship hitting that abutment and just collapsing the entire bridge.
Yeah.
There's video of it. It's just stunning.
All the news channels are all over it. Yeah. There's the video is amazing, and this is a huge bridge, and I guess 30,000 cars normally travel on it every day. The Francis Scott Key Bridge, they're showing it
in Baltimore. The headline here says they're looking for at least 20 people in the water, but because of weather conditions, they're having a hard time even just doing that.
Hmm.
So that doesn't bode well for the people in the water.
Right. Yeah. And it's a breaking news situation. So details are a little sketchy, but they're coming in.
Yeah, but you should check out the video on this bridge collapsing. It's just breathtaking.
Yeah, it really is.
I mean, we were sitting here stunned just looking at the collapsed bridge in the water.
Right.
I mean, that just the span and the amount of destruction is just incredible. And then we saw the video of the bridge collapsing, which happened at around, 1:30 in the morning Eastern time?
Right. So that's 12:30 our time. Is that right?
That's the ship with all the containers on it that hit it.
Yeah. Yeah, it's a huge cargo ship that hit that. They call it the Francis Scott Key Bridge, and it's really, it's a disaster.
Wow. Look at the size of the distance between.
Yeah. Yeah. So we're watching that this morning, and that's going to be a huge story all day.
It is.
Anyway. Well.
That's a downer.
It is. It's tough to start on a, there's still apparently some people in the water, and, you got to be thinking of them. But
They're thinking 20 people, but they don't know how many people are in it. It was pretty late at night.
Yeah.
I was just looking on Wikipedia here. It's about 5 times as long as the interstate bridge that collapsed in 2007.
Wow.
Oh, up in Minnesota?
Yeah.
Woo. Yeah, it's massive, And whatever angle the camera got on this, you can see the entire bridge just coming down. I mean, it must be a security camera or something, quarter mile away or so. That captured. Now they're doing some helicopter video. It's it's a situation.
And Sam mentioned that it's the third longest.
Something about the construction of the bridge. Yeah. Like one of the trusses is the third longest in the world.
Wow.
Yeah.
Well, used to be.
Mm. Yeah, it used to be.
Well, oh boy.
Baltimore, Maryland, where it happened. Okay. back but closer to home
get,
here.
Should we get to the National Day calendar?
Well, that, I guess we should, yeah. We've got it.
Well, do you have something else you want to bring up?
No, first? No. Oh, okay. I just, you know, we got weather today. It's Tuesday.
What day is it today, Gordy?
Well, it's National Day Calendar Tuesday. Today.
It's Tuesday. It's National Day Calendar Day.
Tuesday. Yeah.
Wow.
Is it or is it not? Okay. National Nugget Day. Is it National Spinach Day?
Nougat Day.
Nougat. Yeah. Nougat. Nougat.
Yep,
Nougat. Okay. Nougat. American Diabetes Association Alert Day. Is it Epilepsy Awareness Day or is it Angel Food Cake Day? Which one of those doesn't fit, John?
Angel Food Cake.
How did you know? You look. You look right over at my sheet and
no,
check
I did,
every day.
I did not. I just felt like
it's right there.
Well, that's somebody you probably have in the house that you you probably threw away last night.
No, I would. I don't like Angel Food Cake. I just the texture of
is
it.
Really spongy.
Yeah.
But it only goes good with strawberries.
Yeah. It's too sugary and sweet, you know?
Yeah.
It's just too sweet and the texture is all wrong. It's just, I don't know who invented it, but I don't like it.
But it's very
white.
Should
be banned. It's okay. National Nougat Day. Nougat. That's the word of the day.
Nougat. Yes.
Let's see what that's
it's
all about.
It's a special bean that you find on a plant someplace.
Yeah.
Actually, I have no idea what a nougat is.
National Nougat Day on March 26th celebrates a soft and chewy or sometimes hard and crunchy candy often found at the center of a candy bar.
Oh, just coincidentally, right? It's just there, right? The nougat part
What's
is
this?
Just, it
oh,
just
it's
happens.
A nougat. Yeah. It's made by whipping egg whites together and adding honey or sugar, roasted nuts, and sometimes candied fruits. And some say nougat has been a sweet treat since ancient Rome. Oh, some say.
Were you
is that what
to
they're
say
saying?
Something, Sam, on nougat?
Was I going to say something?
Yeah. Were you going to say
well,
something?
It's like the marshmallow kind of stuff inside of like Milky Way and Snickers bars.
Right.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Precisely. In Italy, some call it Toronto, Torani. In Spain, the nougat is called Turan. I don't know. Do we care? I don't think so.
Well, what about the Three Musketeers?
Care.
Is that the
what
one with the solid nougat?
That one's
that's
all nougat.
All nougat, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Because that's my favorite bar.
Oh, I like Three really? Musketeers,
yeah.
too.
Yeah.
It's kind of light and fluffy on the inside. Got that
exactly.
chocolate
but,
on
know,
the outside.
Other candy bars always, you know, get the credit for having nougat in it. But the Three Musketeers bar doesn't say anything about nougat, and it has all nougat in it.
It's actually at the bottom of the
there's
list.
There's nothing to corrupt it.
They've got a list of candy bars that contain nougat.
Do they?
Yeah. Charleston Chew. When was the last time you even saw Charleston Chew?
I have never seen that.
Mars Bar.
Mm-hmm.
The Mars Bar. I don't think I've seen that for quite a while. Snickers.
Too many peanuts
like Sam
and caramel. Yeah.
Milky Way. And
pure nougat.
Milky Way and Three Musketeers.
Three Musketeers. There you go.
Yeah.
So, okay.
All right.
So we're done. We got it.
Okay. Oh, boys.
Now we know
exhausting.
What to shop for.
Yeah. What else is it today? Let's see. Let's just move
well,
on.
Kind of,
I don't know.
That kind of dominated the discussion here this morning, didn't it?
It did. It did. All right. Here's the other one.
Who knew that nougat would be so popular?
It's National Spinach Day. Here's a food that everybody loves. Spinach. Yeah. Especially Popeye.
Popeye the Sailorman.
Popeye the dirty old Sailorman.
Really creepy.
If you look at some of those old cartoons, it's just amazing what they got away with. National Spinach Day reminds us of the healthy benefits packed into the leafy green vegetable. Not only are there many delicious ways you can enjoy spinach, but it's also incredibly good for you. Now, you have a different take on spinach, I know, don't you?
Well, spinach...
It's not all good.
No, there's oxalates, high oxalates in spinach.
Are you making that word up?
Which,
oxalates?
Which,
what is that?
Which
oxalate.
Which creates the conditions of kidney stones.
Ah.
I really want to avoid kidney stones again.
Yeah?
Never want to go through that.
Not a good thing?
It's like having a baby, only...
How would you know?
Course, much, much shorter.
Much shorter?
But, okay. Well, that's what they say. And I'm just going by... See, what they say.
Do they zap? I mean, do they? Is there anything they can do to?
Yeah, you know what? You can negate the effects of oxalates in spinach by including a dairy product of some sort, like cheese or milk or cream or something like that. So you can negate it. It combines with the oxalate, and it just passes through your system instead of going straight to your kidney, causing kidney stones and extreme pain forever.
That must have been torturous for you. It sounds like it was awful.
It was really bad.
Yeah?
Yes.
How long did it take for it to pass?
Hours, days? Yeah. Well, no, it took hours, but, you know, a lot of time in the emergency department.
Really? No
yeah.
kidding.
Yeah.
And there's really nothing they can do for it.
Yeah, huh? They give you pain relief. That's what they can
something.
Do.
That's something.
But you can't move. I mean, there's no position that you can get that is comfortable. And you're constantly trying to find the comfortable position that never happens.
Okay.
So you go to the, you know, you go to the emergency department and they give you drugs and you're okay, but you got to sit there for, about 8 hours.
Oh, that sounds awful. You know, spinach is eaten raw or cooked or is available fresh, frozen or canned. It's one of the best sources of iron. Iron.
Anybody want to eat spinach now?
It's an excellent source of calcium,
it
folic acid, fiber, protein, calcium, and vitamins A, C, and K.
I put it on pizza all the time because it combines it with dairy.
Oh, there you go. Yep. Yeah, that is good, actually.
Yeah.
I've had spinach on pizza. It's loaded with cancer-fighting antioxidants, and it's believed to help improve cardiovascular and gastrointestinal health. We salute spinach on this National Spinach Day.
We salute it. Because we have nothing else to do in our lives.
Well, it's also Epilepsy Awareness Day. It's also American Diabetes Day.
Yes,
so
absolutely. Again,
and I know we've got some more. We'll come back with History Day. Okay, what is this day in history? All right?
And the Mean Farmer.
And the Mean Farmer.
Oh, yeah. We've got him coming up. We've got some interesting stories for today in history.
Okay. Right around the corner.
Maybe climbing on rainbows, but baby, here goes.
Red.
Great stuff.
Mad Radio 92.7, WMDX, John and Gordy, the morning show. It's 20 past the hour.
I remember I had an incredible girlfriend at that time that, in my personal opinion, was the number one flower girl that I've ever known and ever.
Like
yeah.
a flower child?
Well, yeah, flower child, right?
Yeah. But, you like know, a hippie? No,
flower girl. Yeah.
Thing?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah, and she was just the epitome of that.
And that song brings back those memories,
yeah,
huh?
Of her, yeah. And it was it wasn't an incredible relationship because she lived like 80 miles away from me. So,
were you living around Madison?
No, Milwaukee.
Okay.
Yeah, it was definitely high school. And but, you know, I called her up. I actually looked her up on Facebook. Because I remembered the name. I thought, oh, man, I remembered somebody's name.
Okay.
So I looked it up on Facebook. And I got a hold of her. I just I messaged her.
Wow.
And we talked. And she said, oh, I was wondering about you the other day.
Oh.
And I was thinking, you know, I wonder whatever happened. Why didn't we keep seeing each other? Stuff like that.
Well, and?
And I just told her it was just too far a commute. To see her. Okay, it wasn't 100. It wasn't like 150 miles. It was she lived in South Milwaukee, which is really south of Milwaukee, and
okay.
I was on the west side of Milwaukee, and
wow.
It was just a long drive. That's all.
Yeah. Huh. How long were you together as a couple?
Not very long, you know, 2 or 3 months. But here's the thing, you know, she like wanted. She said, "Well, geez, you know, I did well in my life, but I really wanted, I wish I had gone to Layton School of Art."
Oh,
and I said, you know what?
Went.
That's where I went.
Oh,
so it's like,
you could have,
right. We would have both been going to Layton School of Art, and probably been a happy couple, so on and so forth.
Oh, that's kind of a sad story, John. Thanks for bringing us all down. And that song reminds you of her.
Yes, yes.
Yeah?
Mm-hmm.
Huh.
Yep.
Okay. Why did we play that Bread song anyway? Yeah, because we never hear songs by Bread. David Gates, great songwriter, singer. Is there
a
reason?
I'm glad you asked, Gordy,
because
we have a story about Bread.
Bread?
For today's
besides
history.
Besides my story.
What's the story about Bread?
Well,
are we cracking open the history books?
Okay, so here's the political scene.
All
it's 1804.
Okay.
Thomas Jefferson is the president.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
The Federalist Party, they hate Thomas Jefferson. And so, like the year before, 1803, some lobbyists basically delivered a giant loaf of cheese to Thomas Jefferson.
Because?
Because they were like supporting his policies on religious freedom, basically.
Okay.
And the Federalists made fun of it. They called it the mammoth cheese. So then the next year, 1804, on today, March 26th, the Senate was having a party and they invited Thomas Jefferson. And to commemorate this giant cheese from the year before, they made a giant loaf of bread. Take a guess at how big this loaf of bread was.
Wow, really?
Yeah, how big were the ovens back then? I mean, how could they?
They must have had to, like, construct an oven specifically for this loaf of bread. This loaf of bread was 12 feet long.
No.
2 foot by 2 foot.
Wow.
2 by 2 by 12?
Yeah.
Good heavens.
48 cubic feet of bread.
Jeez. I mean,
that must have been a fun party, huh?
Yeah. It allegedly quickly devolved into, like, a drunken mess in the White House.
I would think so. It goes well with cheese.
Yeah,
they had fun back in the olden days.
I'm sure they
with
did.
With the Senate.
And how did they prevent the bread from not collapsing or something like that?
I don't know.
A huge, huge loaf of bread, long as heck, and the oven must be insane.
So it devolved into a drunken mess, you said.
Yes,
so immediately
allegedly.
When they saw the big loaf of bread,
they
let's just start drinking.
Cause... Yeah, they had drinks. They had roast beef at this party, apparently,
really?
Served with the bread.
Oh, that's amazing history.
See,
it's like having Arby's.
See, this is where history kind of went off on the wrong direction because, you know, the Federalists, of course, have basically gotten every one of our horrible right-wing justices on the Supreme
Court.
Federalists. Instead, it could have been the Federalist Bread Company.
Exactly.
It could have been.
What
could have or should have been.
Exactly.
Yeah, if it had only taken a different twist. Anything else going on this day in history?
Another 23rd? Significant political thing. 1812, the word gerrymander was coined in a political cartoon. Yeah.
Wow.
Wow. Okay.
And was there a reason why they called it gerrymander?
I believe it was named after one of the legislators in power at the time who drew the maps.
And his name Jerry?
Yes. And it supposedly looked like a salamander, so gerrymander.
There you go.
All right. What else happened on March 26th on this date, Sam?
Are either of you fans of Doctor Who?
Yes.
Yeah, kind of.
There were certain years that we liked.
Yeah, the early ones.
Well, when the series rebooted in 2005, today was the debut episode.
Ah. Yeah. Who is the star? Do you know? Do you have any indication?
I don't remember the name of the first
Doctor. That tall guy with the hair. What was his name? Yeah. Doctor Who fans out there.
Well, the guy with a crazy scarf. I mean, he was
Tom Baker.
Tom Baker.
Yeah,
it was him. Yeah.
They had, I'm trying to think of a guy that everybody really, really liked as Doctor Who.
I don't know.
And the last guy, you know, with the long gray hair.
Like in the new series?
Newer series.
Yeah. Oh, gosh. What's his name?
I don't know. We came prepared this morning.
We didn't know we were going to be talking about Doctor Who.
Anyone text us?
I haven't watched it for like 10 years.
Yeah.
Get on the Civic Media app here in Texas and let us know. You know, we're floundering here, folks. We're not going to survive this section of the show.
Well.
Two more minutes.
We can ask the Google machine here. About
we've got
Who.
Some birthdays that we can talk about in those 2 minutes.
Okay, you go ahead and do that.
Today, 1874, Robert Frost was born. Doctor Who. Supreme Court Justice Sandra Day O'Connor was born in 1930 on this day. Spock, Mr. Leonard Nimoy, the year after in 1931.
Mm-hmm.
Nancy Pelosi, 1940. Diana Ross, 1944. And Steven Tyler, 1948.
There have been 13 Doctor Who's.
Oh, there have.
Look at this.
Okay. Well, I'll tell you which ones.
Well, the show's been running for like
forever.
Almost 60 years. Yeah.
I'll tell you which one everybody really liked. No one liked Matt Smith. Okay. No one liked him.
What?
Tom Baker.
No one liked him.
Tom Baker?
Tom Baker was the guy that everybody remembers with the crazy scarf.
And, right.
And Peter Capaldi was one of the last guys to do it. He had long hair, a crazy looking guy. In fact, fantastic Doctor Who, I thought, anyway.
Okay.
And the other one is...
There was David Tennant, right?
David
Matt
Tennant,
Smith.
That's who I'm looking at. I can't find him here. They don't even have him listed. Yeah, David Tennant is the guy that everybody really, really liked. And I think it's only because they had incredible writers at the time that did some great episodes.
Okay.
Yeah.
Going back in time with Doctor Who.
Or into the future.
Or into the future. Way. That's right. Is there currently a Doctor Who, or is it off?
It's still on.
Yes,
they had a female Doctor Who.
Jodie Whittaker.
There is a Doctor Who booth that is all over town. I don't know if it changes places, but they have a Doctor Who booth at like Knutson and...
are you talking
seriously, on the east side they have a booth.
Okay. Dr. 29 pass. Back with more of John and Gordy. Got a minute or two.
They called it the booth. The Targus. Yeah, there's a Targus that they have all over
Madison?
Yes. Yes, it's big. It's just life size. It's actually the thing. I'm trying to figure out where it is. Knutson and let me see. Yeah, I think it's always there. It might be the people that own the property that put it there. But it may not be.
Okay. They can what?
Receive decades-old TV signals from space. Like when they were initially broadcast, they go out to space, they bounce off of something, and then they come back.
They come back?
Yeah. And so they've been able to receive, like...
Really?
...transmissions of Doctor Who before.
No.
Good Lord, that's impossible.
Really?
How is that even possible?
There were some lost episodes because they destroyed the tapes, and then they were able to refine them.
You're bullshit.
I want proof of this. Okay.
So they
look it up.
The signal was so strong that they could actually record the episodes. That is just ridiculous. I can't get a signal on the internet.
How far out clear. Would it have to go and then come back 50 years later?
Okay, there's
the
a boot.
Speed of light.
Okay. Yeah.
You have to disperse and everything.
Why would it be, coincidentally, why would it be Doctor Who episodes? All right, I'll tell you what, we got to talk about this. We're going to have to go through this.
Was something out of an action movie. Jeez. We're comparing everything to movies now. They're saying there's still people in the water. 6 hours later.
Not quite.
Well, they're in the water. They're not.
Lifeless.
Yeah.
Or maybe trapped.
Look at that. Jesus. Yeah, they might be trapped under the bridge.
Doesn't look that deep right there.
Yeah, I wouldn't want to be there.
No.
Let's see what ABC is saying. So, do you have a live radio signal in there?
I can pull it up, yeah.
Yeah, well, let's hear what it... I want to compare it to our Civic Media app signal and see if it's live, or almost live. Or... There's Pam Yonke.
They got somebody.
Up 32 cents right now at 16.07. May melts up 33 cents at 1665 a hundredweight. Yesterday, the Texas Department of Agriculture.
This is like a half second ahead of this.
Serious disease is that's been impacting dairy cattle. In the highly pathogenic avian influenza. Now, unlike poultry, this will not kill cattle, but it does make them sick for a few days before they recover and get back to regular milk production. I'm Farm Director Pam Yonke.
You're listening to Mad Radio WMDX, Madison's home.
Okay, what are we coming out with here? Trump doesn't like evangelicals, or are we going to talk about Doctor Who? And
we're going to help talk Doctor Who and then the Mean Farmer.
Oh, Mean Farmer. What's the Mean Farmer going to talk about today? Whoa, look at this angle. At least you're
FM at 1580 AM. And we were talking about Doctor Who.
Right.
The best Doctor Who. Who was that?
Who?
Who was the best Doctor Who?
There were a lot of them. There are tons of them.
Okay. It's not a fumble so much as a Tarkus. That's what they call it. They had to give it a special name, you know.
Okay.
Just to confuse people.
Yeah.
But if you want to go see one, it is, I would assume it's still there, it's at Knutson Drive and Westport Road.
Okay.
It's right at the corner. So you would should that definitely, be? That's
east side?
It's just south of Northport Drive.
Oh, okay.
Yep, east side.
All right.
Definitely.
So we can check it out?
Yeah, you can check it out.
Take a picture.
It should be. It's been there for a long time.
Huh.
Yeah.
Okay.
A life-size Targus. Just sitting there, unless, of course, you know, Doctor Who found a way to leave the east side and go to the west side. Who knows?
What if the Mean Farmer ever watched Doctor Who.
Well, I can't imagine.
Talk about worlds colliding.
Yes. Yeah. Now, were you? Now, Sam was talking about seeing a reflection of Doctor Who off the moon. Is that
Yeah. What are you talking?
Is that correct now?
Where we can see old TV episodes by bouncing them off the moon? What are you talking?
This was something that I first heard about in like middle school when I was a lot more gullible.
You've been carrying it around for a while.
Huh? Well, I just haven't thought about it for quite a long time. But yeah, there was a hoax once upon a time that like decades old TV broadcasts would be able to bounce off things in distant space and reflect back to Earth, so you could receive the original transmission long time after it happened.
That's
which is not the case because the signal just like gets too weak the further out you go.
Yeah, it dissipates.
But you can bounce radio signals off the moon pretty easily.
Okay.
That's like how you see the moon at night. It's just the moon reflecting light from the sun.
Okay.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
All right.
You know, there was a science fiction television episodic show of some sort. I can't remember which one it was, but it was called Distant Signals. And these aliens were just addicted to this earthly detective series.
Is this a comedy?
It's just a fictional story, you know, a short story that they adapted to TV. And these aliens came to Earth because they canceled the show before it could end correctly. So they came to Earth, they looked up the actors, they found a director that originally did the show. These are all aging people now. And they said, well, you really want us to do this? And so they filmed the last episode for the aliens on another planet so they could air that and watch it and have finality to their favorite TV show.
No, one of the movies that I was showing over this weekend at the theater had a plot something like that.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. It was about aliens who their entire knowledge of humanity was based off of what they saw on TV.
Yes. Mm-hmm. That's right.
Wow.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Distant signals.
Speaking of aliens and the moon, everyone knows that the moon's made out of cheese, right?
Sure. Mm-hmm. Okay.
Well, today, guess what the mean farmer is talking about?
Cheese?
You'd be right, Gordy.
Let's listen.
Okay.
Let's find out.
Hey, here he comes now.
Hi. This is the Mean Farmer, and this week on the Mean Farmer Show, cheese. Oh, yeah. Cheese. Listen to the sound of that word. Cheese. Sounds like what it is, don't it? Cheese. Gotta love it. Like hell. Cheese. Reason I'm bringing it up is because my cousin Norbert from Wisconsin, he wrote me a letter, said he wanted to come live with me. I said, nope. I mean, he's just too mean. I'm the mean farmer, but he's a dairy farmer. Whew. Ever seen the machines them guys use? A Freudian nightmare. Call me mean. Personally, my cows and I prefer the personal touch. Anyway, with milk prices being what they are, Norbert's in way too bad a mood to be my roommate. Anyway, him being from Wisconsin got me thinking about cheese. Now, I don't like cheese. Don't like it. Oh, you know what cheese is. I mean, you know you do. You know. It's controlled spoilage. Yeah, it's just the other side of fresh. It's cheese. Don't like it? Won't touch it. Cheese. I mean, I won't touch Swiss. It's them bubbles. What made them bubbles? I know what made them bubbles. You know what made them bubbles. Gas. What kind of gas? Oh, I know what kind of gas. You know what kind of gas. Cheese gas. You slice into a fresh slab. Who cut the cheese? Where do you think that saying came from? Out of thin air? What about Limburger or blue cheese? I mean, first, they don't know how to spell blue, and second, it smells like gym shoes, old sneakers, rotten tennis. It's the same bacteria, you know. Don't believe me? Ask a scientist. He'll tell you. What about Brie? You eat Brie, you develop an overpowering urge to buy a Volvo, Calvin Klein sport coats, bottled water, renovated Victorian home, listen to NPR, and a compulsion to start up a software firm. Weird stuff, Brie. Whew. Next week on the Mean Farmer Show, real cheese. I mean, my favorite, only kind I'll eat. Comes in this little plastic wrappers, individual slices.
Oh, no. Oh, my God.
Oh, boy.
The worst.
Mean farmer.
Processed cheese.
Yeah. Jeez.
By the way, I looked up the television show that I was talking about, Distant Signals.
Yeah.
It's a great show. Darren McGavin, remember him?
Oh,
from
sure.
A Christmas Story?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, he was the star. He was the detective in this fake TV show.
Okay.
And it was a show on Tales from the Dark Side.
All right.
And somebody texted us Galaxy Quest. Is that a similar story?
It was like a science fiction TV show, I believe,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Kind of a modern, I don't know. It was just... kind of like a soap opera in space or something.
Oh,
I don't
it?
Know. Well, yeah, look it up. We got time. 6:41 coming up in about 25 minutes or so. We will reveal the ride into spring keyword for the 7 o'clock.
Well, what is
hour.
That keyword this time?
Well, I can't tell you till after 7 o'clock. That's the rules. You know, it happens at 7 o'clock, 10 o'clock, 1 o'clock, and 3 o'clock. Different keywords for each of those hours.
Right,
okay, so be listening. Okay, Galaxy Quest.
Is a 1990 American science fiction comedy film.
Yeah.
It's pretty fun. A parody of a homage to science fiction films and series, especially Star Trek and the Fandom.
Fandom.
Oh, yeah. It's Fandom. The film depicts the cast of a fictional cult television series, Galaxy Quest, who are drawn into it. This is really small print. I'm having a hard time reading this.
It doesn't matter. That's this person texted back. That's the movie that Sam was talking about.
Ah.
Okay. Sam, does any of that ring a bell?
It was actually a different movie. It was called Explorers, but
okay.
this is closer to what John was talking about than what
matter.
We showed over the weekend.
And that is our program director, Kathleen,
yes.
is contributing to the show. I like the way she started that. Idiots. That's the movie Sam mentioned.
Well, okay. How did we know that?
We're struggling.
Yeah.
All right. Thank
Obviously.
You.
I feel a meeting coming on now. Okay.
There goes the Rays.
It's 49 degrees, but it's getting colder, and it's going to get windy through the day.
There's down a chilly wind in our messages here.
Yes, the cold front's moving right through the studio right now. It's going to be windy, too, so watch out for the rain and, you know, there's some ponding, some flash flooding out there this morning, so slow down, take it easy, allow some extra travel time,
big
blah,
story.
Blah, blah. Oh, yeah.
Baltimore Bridge
collapse. Tragic story this morning.
Yeah,
7 people at least unaccounted for. The Baltimore Bridge collapse. The Francis Scott Key Bridge got run into by a freighter. And there's all the news stations are all over it this morning. There's a lot of video. And
it's incredible. Yeah, and they have video. They have video of the bridge actually collapsing.
Yeah,
which is just jaw dropping.
Stunning.
Yeah, it is. All right. Why don't we get to just a little politics here.
Okay.
Let's sprinkle that into the show as we talk about old TV shows.
Okay.
So anyway, Eric Swalwell, Representative Eric Swalwell, was able to declare the Biden impeachment dead, and he did it in a very flashy way. But
did he?
At the end of this, he goes to a whiteboard, and he puts the day that it ended.
Okay.
And that was a couple of days ago. But I thought it was just nice the way he summarized everything, 561. All right, let's listen to Eric Swalwell's final comments on the impeachment.
Okay.
It's time to pack it up. And I want to give you the top 10 reasons why impeachment is dead. Number 10, your key witness today is testifying from the slammer. Number 9, key evidence of a bribe that you all relied on. The guy who said that has been indicted for lying about that bribe, and he's a Russian asset.
Oops.
Number 8, another key witness has been indicted as a Chinese agent. Number 7, during the Hunter Biden interview, Mr. Chairman, you didn't even stay for the whole time. Number 6, Chairman Jason Smith didn't show up at all to the Hunter Biden interview. The same day, number 5, Daryl Issa said, it's a big nothing. Number 4, today Jim Jordan began his remarks not by relying on any evidence for this investigation, but he went off attacking the DOJ about what they're doing with the Catholics. Number 3, you all still have not sent the articles of impeachment for the Mayorkas impeachment to the Senate. And that happened last month. Number two, you're now talking about a criminal referral, but if you had evidence for a criminal referral, then you have evidence to impeach somebody for high crimes and misdemeanors. And number one, and I'm sorry to say this, Fox News isn't even carrying this today. In fact, one of their anchors, as they broke away 10 minutes in, said, this is the same hearing over and over and over. At what point are you gonna fish or cut bait? So I just have to tell you, it's over. Impeachment's over. Dunzo. Bye-bye. Rigor mortis. Lights out.
Wow.
Curtain drop.
All right.
Mic drop.
Yep.
Peace. Adios.
Yep.
Sayonara. Au revoir. Or a language that you all understand. Doi civ dania. Did I say that right, Mr. Parnas?
Yes.
I dare you impeach. But you won't, because you don't have the evidence. And because you don't have the evidence, you don't have the votes.
Whiteboard.
Guys, it's dead. And so I'm here to pronounce the time of death.
Writing it on the whiteboard. Yeah. There it is. Done. I don't know what date it was, but
that was pretty amazing.
They're continuing the investigation and the impeachment. It's not ending. It's not ending.
Mm.
And you know, they want to keep it alive and well all the way up to November.
Give it up.
They,
I mean,
they
come on.
They actually want to do this.
That's nuts.
They think we're going to just fall for it and let them do it.
Sure.
But I think the Democrats have, you know, Swalwell wasn't the only one to declare it dead. I think every Democrat there did. And these guys are like, well, you know, we still have so many more things to cover and
really
so many more things to look at and so many more documents to peruse and make sure they're not all just redacted, but we want the unredacted stuff now.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Well, he's right. It's over.
Yeah.
Yeah. Move on. Nothing to see here.
That's right.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Forget about it.
They just want to attack Biden.
Yeah.
And call into question his ability to run the country. And that's just what it's all about. Who cares? You know. I mean, look, it is dead in our brains. It's dead. In their heads, their brains are dead.
Yeah.
All right, let's get into something else here. And this is kind of an interesting find for somebody.
Mm-hmm.
They discovered that Trump does not like evangelicals at all. He's actually said this.
Mm-hmm.
You've got something?
Well, no. We're just keeping an eye on the clock here. Maybe we can come back with this.
We don't have time for this?
Probably not.
Do you have a soundbite?
Probably not.
Yeah.
No.
We're okay. We'll cover this in just a moment.
Yeah, we're coming right back, though.
Yeah.
Okay?
Okay, well, that's good.
Okay.
Unless Catherine sends us a message saying, no, you're not coming back, idiots.
It is 6:49, 49 degrees. John and Gordy on a Tuesday morning with you. We'll be back in 60 seconds.
Maybe.
Or not. Out of power, former president in control of foreign policy.
What is it? Out of power.
Trump, 4B.
Oh, yeah, 4B.
Yeah.
Oh, I can't find any of this stuff.
Maybe I've got it.
Here it is. I got it. It's cut
579.
Got 5B. Oh. No. Oh, shoot. I got the wrong one. That's the wrong one.
Yeah, what are you talking about next?
Out of power. Here, I got it.
20 seconds.
Yeah, that's 579. Okay. Mad Radio WMDX 92.7 FM at 1580 AM. This is the John and Gordy Show, a show about nothing.
Which we prove every morning right here from 6 to 8 a.m. Yeah.
Wasn't that a great revelation? Great episode, great series of episodes.
Seinfeld? Yeah.
Yeah.
Show you know what nothing. I like to watch is all the bloopers that show up now.
Oh, yeah?
I've never seen a lot of these bloopers before. Mm. They're pretty good. Where the cast, just, they can't get through the script. Sometimes it's so funny. Anyway. All right. 6:51. And raining this morning, 49 degrees.
Currently. I think Curb Your Enthusiasm had a whole bunch of Seinfeld.
Oh, sure. They actually
they
had
all
a,
got back together.
Yeah, there was a reunion. Yeah. Yeah, a reunion episode about putting the show back together.
Larry David.
Yeah. Yep, the whole cast.
Yep.
Yeah. Okay.
So we get, should we get into the idea that Trump doesn't like evangelicals?
Get onto something. Yeah. Why wouldn't he like evangelicals? They've been with him since the beginning, right?
Oh, yeah.
They've been in his corner.
Oh, sure.
They like him.
Well, he doesn't like anybody, really.
No, he doesn't.
Right. He's in love with himself. Come on, please. Now, this is a reminder from late last year, the book, The Kingdom, the Power, and the Glory, American Evangelicals in an Age of Extremism. By Tim Aberta. He was an influencer and a reporter, and he wrote this in The Atlantic. In the heat of the Republican primary in 2016, Donald Trump called evangelical supporters of his rival Ted Cruz so-called Christians and real pieces of, starts with S, a new book says. In private, over the coming years, Trump would use even more colorful language to describe the evangelical community, the ones who support him and believe that he is Jesus, basically. All right, so just to let you know that he's just lying when he reaches out to the evangelical crowd.
Okay.
The second coming. And that's what, and that's him, basically, okay?
Yeah. So that's what he thinks.
Yeah, that's what he thinks. But you know what? There's some truth to it. This guy is a former president. He's not the real president anymore. He thinks he might be, and he never lost the election. I get that. And his followers actually believe that.
Delusional.
They believe that Biden is controlled by Obama. Okay.
Right.
all sorts of different things. Or that maybe Biden is an alien, I'm sorry. So. Well, anyway, this is interesting stuff. The Atlantic writer, Ann Applebaum, had this unsettling thought. Captured this little voicer.
Okay.
Check it out.
You know, he's been very, very clear that he doesn't want the House to pass this money. And there are enough people in the House who either support him or are afraid for their own seats, they're afraid of being primaried, that they have gone along with it. And I think that, more than anything else, explains where we are. I mean, it's really an extraordinary moment, and we have a out-of-power ex-president who is, in effect, dictating American foreign policy on behalf of a foreign dictator or with the interests of a foreign dictator in mind. And I don't think we've been through this before.
There? Crazy, isn't it?
It is.
And I've been saying it all along. It's like he's never left office, and he's calling the shots.
Yeah.
And
you,
no, he is.
Well,
and he's talking to all these world leaders. He's still meeting with them. you know, who knows how much money he's asking them to give.
So, well, that's right. He's still got his hand out.
Everybody believes at this point now he's fairly compromised, and it's a good conclusion to make.
Yeah, and yet it goes on and on. He still thinks he's in charge.
That's right.
He's got all the contacts.
Now, we talked about Trump. Let's talk about the cult that follows Trump.
Okay.
The MAGAs say the darndest things, and I have cut 505 here, I believe. I don't know if we've played that already.
The Borg Genesis, we heard that, I think, yesterday.
Oh, let's go to 542 then. Let's go to 542 and listen to more of what the MAGAs are saying, the darndest things of.
Okay.
Tell me about if Donald Trump does not win, what do you do?
I hope that I'm going to die.
You want to die if Donald Trump doesn't win?
I don't want to live like this anymore. You like our country the way it is now?
It's hard for me to give credit to a person of, like Obama for all the reasons that I think are true about him that is not in the mainstream media.
Like what?
Well, him and his favorite beau, Michael. Oh, I'm sorry. I meant that Michelle.
Oh, no. Oh,
and I could go on. There's no sense of going further than that. All right.
I mean his wife?
I mean the person that he cohabitates with, yes.
The mother of his two daughters?
Okay, say what you want, but I don't believe that for an instant either. I don't believe that that Michael had any children.
Michael who?
One that you call Michelle Obama.
That's his wife. They were. You don't agree with that? That's his wife?
I agree that's his mate.
No, I think they've been after him so long that all of this is just a witch hunt, like he described it. I don't think there's anything Trump's done wrong. I think that the desperate opposition is just after him. I mean, they started out, you know, and they've been after him eight different ways, and they're going to keep after him until they can get him in jail, I think.
People can't see beyond this politicalization of the Justice Department. Then I would say they suffer from Trump derangement syndrome.
There are people that think that you suffer from.
Yeah, but they don't have an argument. They just don't like Trump.
If Trump were to lose for the second time, what would you think the reset would have to be for Republicans?
I would say things would get so bad, it'll be almost in a communist type of zone to where we may not even be able to farm anymore.
What are people not talking about that they should?
We're not talking about our worldview. Everybody's laughing at America because we have the weakest president we've ever had in history. He likes everybody but America. Well, because he's crooked. He's gotten a lot of money, millions over the years with his son, Hunter. But the thing that is, Russia, China, everybody's laughing because we have no strength. We are not the America of 10 years ago.
What does woke mean?
Yeah. Woke means it's like policies and in the schools and companies that are forcing people basically to just go along with the tide. When people are, a lot of people don't even want it, but they're just doing it because they don't want to fight.
So like LGBTQ rights, is that forcing people to?
Not rights. I mean, like I said, everybody should have rights, but like it's really being forced upon children in schools. Like the things that are being taught to them, like they're having, like parents don't have rights anymore. Like the rights of parents are being diminished and the rights of the government and the school system are being expanded. And so our kids are in danger. Yeah. I mean, kids are getting mutilated and making choices like cut off your body parts.
The gender reassignment, if that's what you're
talking about. Just all those things.
Yeah, it's all those things.
Okay. Wow. It is 6:58, wrapping up our first hour of John and Gordy for this Tuesday. We're coming right back. All right.
What? Woo. Was that cut 5:42? Yes. Okay. Checking them off here. It's a slow week.
How far? You can't see because of the fog and the rain.
Yeah, now the fog.
But it hits there, but it knocked it all the way down, all the way back.
Tanker ship.
Must have been out of control because there's no, I mean, it doesn't look like that bridge was supposed to be up or anything. It looks like a, you know, it's just a regular bridge. Not a, what do you call it? Open bridge.
Right. Yeah, it wasn't a drawbridge.
We've got a guest coming. The Mallards guy is walking.
Oh, yeah, 7 o'clock, right?
Yeah, I got to do the keyword thing.
Do we know what? Do we have any questions?
We should always have Sam supplies. Questions. Run by them. Suggested questions, topics. They have a new softball team, women's softball team. They're naming it. I think they're down to the final few names. So yeah, the women's softball team. I think it's maybe even a new league. I don't know.
Okay, got
Did you pick a name yet? Pick a name. When when's the seasons? When's the mallard season start? When's the this new?
Got it. How about the beverages, huh? Do they have bugs?
Morning.
Good morning. How are you?
Good.
I'm Sam.
I'm John.
Nice to meet you.
Nice, Gordy.
Thanks for having me.
You bet.
Appreciate it.
You're going to be sitting right there.
Right here.
Got a mic for you and headphones. And
amazing.
You like some water or do you have some coffee or
Thank
something?
You.
Okay.
All right. Let me get the headphones.
Sam, what is your position with the Mallards?
I'm the general manager.
Okay. Of the Mallards?
Yes.
Okay.
And softball.
Okay. Now you haven't picked. We'll ask you some of these questions,
okay.
But the contest isn't over. Are you down to finalists for the name of the team, or have you picked it?
The name is done.
It is.
So our
don't
voting
tell us.
Is over.
Okay.
Well, I'm not telling you.
Have you revealed?
Are you going to tell us?
I can tell you off air.
Oh,
when
no.
will you reveal it to the general
April
public?
April 20th.
Okay.
There's a big event at the Orpheum.
Oh, really? Mm-hmm. Okay. Orpheum. All right. All right, we're in news right now, and so you have a few minutes, like 4 or 5 minutes.
Cool.
I'm going to do a little contest thing. You know, we'll do a little weather. We'll do a couple of minutes before we introduce you.
Totally. Sounds good.
And we'll take it from there.
Awesome.
Yeah.
How long have you been with the Mallards?
I'm going into my third season.
Okay.
So.
Are you from Madison?
Nope, I'm from Florida.
What are you doing up here?
I know. Got a good job, so.
Well, you know, summers are fairly humid here, so you should be right at home.
Yeah, summer's good. So, what about you guys? Are you guys from the area?
Yep, Wisconsin all the days
really?
Of my life.
That's awesome.
I'm from the Chicago area, so
okay.
I'm a transplant.
Yeah.
He's been around.
I've been up here 30-ish years or so.
Oh, yeah.
He's been all over the country. He's
traveled all.
Globetrotting. Son of a
That's awesome. All
right.
Where's your favorite place?
Oh, well, I love Wisconsin.
There's the bridge collapse right there.
Yeah, that was crazy.
It is, yeah.
I used to live in Maryland.
Did
so,
you really?
Yeah.
Look at that. The ship had to be out of control.
Just completely.
Yeah.
The entire bridge, they're saying. Well, yeah, I mean, you know, if any section of the bridge, that's the entire bridge. Oh, God. All right.
So when's the season start?
Mallards is May 28th, and softball is June 16th.
Okay, so what is the final age?
Can't tell anyone.
God.
Oh, no.
Okay, well, that does it. We're going to the... The gloves are off.
Oh, no. I'll tell you after.
Okay.
It'll be
fine. I know. I tried to cheat a little bit.
I know it was. Can you reveal what the five final? Okay.
The final four.
All right. Just hold on,
Absolutely.
You know.
All right.
I think people can hear this.
Yeah, we're on Facebook.
Facebook. So. They hear everything between the.
Yeah.
Really?
transmitted by wire.
Here is the latest news brought into your own living room.
You'll be hard to satisfy with anything less.
Let's give them something to talk about.
Talk is cheap.
Gib, gib, gib. Who is gossiping?
It's the John and Gordy Show.
This is Hi-Fi Plus.
And that's the way it is.
We'll do it live.
Only on Mad Radio 92.7 WMDX. Take it away, boys.
Oh, we'll take it somewhere.
Yes.
6 minutes past the hour, John and Gordy, the morning show on this Tuesday, the 26th day of March.
Fairly wet day today.
It's raining, and it's going to get windy and cold. Right now, 49 degrees. Get down into the upper 30s later today, and then it gets cold overnight and cold tomorrow.
Yep.
Okay.
All right.
All right. It's we're into the 7 o'clock hour, and guess what? It's time for our Ride into Spring Text to Win contest. Time for the keyword.
What is that keyword?
For this, well, I'll tell you in just a moment, John. I have to explain that if people want to enter, if they don't know how to enter, this is a text to win. So you have to get the Civic Media app, mm-hmm. which is a free app.
Right.
You can get it at the Google Play Store or the Apple Store or anywhere you can get apps. You can get the Civic Media app. You go onto the app.
Yep.
You go to the Mad Radio portion of it or right. any of our other fine Civic Media stations, mm-hmm. and you'll find a text button there. And you just text the word, the keyword for this hour, for the 7 o'clock hour, is trip, okay? T-R-I-P, right. trip, okay? That's the keyword. So you enter into that, and you could win an overnight stay at Chula Vista in Wisconsin Dells.
Wow.
And we'll have giveaways at 7 a.m., 10 a.m., 1 p.m., and 3 p.m. Those are all different keyword hours.
Heavy
okay?
trip. It's a heavy
it's
trip.
A trip. Trip is the key word. We've got other prizes, too. Once you enter, you're also entered into our two grand prizes that include brand-new bicycles, a 3-in-1 blender, and outdoor patio love seat, all kinds of cool prizes. Yeah. So, again, the key word for the 7 o'clock hour here is trip, okay?
It's a heavy trip, man.
This is a statewide contest. All the Civic Media stations are in on the contest, okay?
Life's a heavy trip, man.
Okay. Stop saying that, all right? We have a guest in the studio, John.
Yes, we do.
We want to welcome Sam Rubin from the Madison Mallards. Good morning, Sam. Thanks
morning.
For coming in.
Yeah, thanks for
He's
having me.
He's in control of the whole shooting match over there.
Everything.
Yep, everything. And
How long have you been with the Mallards?
Yeah, how long has it been?
Yeah, so I'm going into my third season with the Mallards.
Good all for right. you.
Yeah.
Now,
is this a job you got while you were in Florida?
So I did a stint out in Maryland with a team out there for 2 years, 3 years, mm-hmm. something like that. And then after that, I came out here.
Mm-hmm.
So
originally from Florida?
Yep,
is
from the Tampa Bay area.
Yeah.
Yeah.
A lot of baseball down in Florida.
Lots of baseball.
Yeah. So you kind of grew up in maybe in a baseball loving family, right?
Sort of. I'm a big Tampa Bay Rays fan, which is super disappointing at all times.
Always, yeah. They don't seem to do very well.
Well, they do. They just never actually win it. But
is that a trouble farm drawing team? Crowds
is that a
down
farm
there.
Team, oh, yeah.
No, it's not a farm
no,
team.
No, no. It should. It might as well be though.
Okay.
Yeah, crowds not so great. No, but no. I'm a big Rays fan, so
yeah.
I grew up a Rays fan and went to Devil Rays games when I was a kid. And
sure. Mm-hmm.
So love baseball.
Play baseball yourself?
I played softball in high school, and then I was actually a rower in college.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yep.
So, now when does the Madison Mallards team start their season?
Yeah, so opening day this year is May 28th.
Okay.
It's a Tuesday, right after Memorial Day. So the day after Memorial Day is when we open up. And then, of course, we have softball coming this year,
this
too.
Is new, right?
Yes.
The softball, the women's softball team.
Yes.
And you've selected a name. What were the five finalist names?
Yeah, so there were four finalist names.
Four finalists. Okay.
One was the Swamp Angels.
Mm-hmm. All right.
One was the Nightmares, as in like two words.
Okay.
One was the Lake Munsters, like Munster cheese.
Right. Okay.
And the last one was the Thunder Chickens.
Thunder Chickens.
Yes.
Thunder chickens.
Okay. Yep.
And which one did you select?
I can't tell you that.
What do you mean? Wait, you can't tell us?
No.
Why not?
So it was all community-driven voting. So all of these names were fan submissions.
Okay.
So everyone submitted
a
name.
Sure, you're off the hook. Okay.
Yeah, then. Exactly. What? So if no one likes it, it's not our fault.
So when will you be revealing the name?
Yeah, so April 20th, which is a Saturday night, we'll have a big event at the Orpheum. So it's a free event. It's family friendly. We'll have face painters and carnival games and snacks and all the good things. We'll do a big unveil video with a big hoopla of all the stuff going on. So 5 o'clock is when doors open, and then 5:30 is when the actual unveil begins.
Now, you have all these names. Now, did you have like logos tied to them, artist renderings of what the logo would would look like?
Yeah, so we had some preliminary stuff. To be honest, when we opened up the last round of voting, so the final four names, it was a pretty clear winner from day one.
Because of the logo or because of the name?
We didn't release any of the logos. So because of the name.
What was the last one? The chickens? What was it?
The Thunder Chickens.
The Thunder Chickens. See, I thought it was a bad choice only because, you know, people would pick their favorite parts.
Right.
And you don't want that reference for a women's team, right?
Yeah, there you go.
Okay. So let's rule that out. Can we say, can we rule that out?
I cannot confirm nor deny.
Okay.
So what was the first one?
Oh, geez.
Come on.
The Lake Monsters.
No, not that one.
The Swamp Angels.
Swamp Angels.
And the Nightmares.
The Nightmares. I bet that's the one that won. Okay.
She can't reveal it,
Maybe.
John.
Maybe. We'll see. April 20th. Come find out. Okay. I'd love to have you guys.
All right.
So, Sam, how do you go about putting together a brand new team for this? What league are they going to be in? What is this women's softball
league of their own? Or
okay,
no, that would be cool, but no, it's the Northwoods League softball. So the Mallards are part of the Northwoods League baseball, the Northwoods League started a softball league, and so we're a part of that. This is the first year of the entire league, so not just the Madison team, but the entire thing. And the interesting part about this setup is that this doesn't actually exist anywhere else. There's no summer collegiate softball that ties in the fun minor league baseball feels to it as well. So there is summer collegiate softball, but it's all player driven, or it's all development driven and drills and that sort of thing. We don't have the tickets and the giveaways and the fun stuff that comes with it.
So how do you put this league? I mean, where do you draft these players from? And how did that all work? Did they audition, or I mean, not
audition.
You know, I mean, do they have exhibition games, or how do you get the talent?
It's all recruiting, so it's just like how we recruit the Mallards. We have relationships with coaches around the country and reach out to them and ask them who they have interest in sending. We have a head coach as well. She'll actually be here for the event. Her name is Raquel. She's from California, and she's recruiting the team. So she's scouting players. She's reaching out to college coaches and asking if there's interest in sending their players up here.
So the Mallards have the duck pond, right? Okay. Is there a separate field for the... Okay, so you play on the same field, same dimensions?
Nope, different dimensions. Okay. So actually, as we speak, they are tearing up our infield. We are getting turf this season.
Okay.
So our infield will be turf. It'll be adjustable sizes for not only softball, but also for youth. So there's a really great component where haven't really ever been able to do a lot of youth games out there.
Mm-hmm.
And so now with the adjustable field, we can. So... yeah, it'll be really, really cool. So literally the infield is torn up and there's bulldozers and all the things out there, and it's pretty cool.
So the Mallards open their season May 28th, did you say?
Yes, correct.
And the women's softball team yet to be named?
Yes.
June?
June 16th. Okay. It's actually Father's Day. So.
Oh, that'll be great.
Yeah, it's a Sunday, so it'll be perfect.
Okay. Are there pro teams that are interested in the Mallards?
What do you mean by that?
Do pro teams take players from...
So all of our... Even the Mallards are all college-aged.
Okay.
So both softball and the Mallards are all current college students. So it's not like a farm team.
So they're not a Class A or a Class B.
Correct. So these are all current college athletes.
Got it.
We recruit from... I went to the University of Florida, so we recruit from the University of Florida, of course.
Sure.
We recruit from Madison College. We recruit from UW now for softball. We recruit everywhere, all over the country. We can recruit players for now both softball and baseball.
Well, you know, let's talk about all over the country for women's softball.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. I mean, is this taking off all over the country? You know, we have it here, but is this happening everywhere now?
Not yet, but I think in my opinion, we always like to say that baseball is good for baseball, and same thing for softball. Softball is good for softball. So if after this we end up with competitive leagues that are trying to compete with us, like I think that's a good thing. Softball is starting to take off, but there's nothing like this yet.
Now, when I watch a women's softball, I'm amazed at the pitchers,
because
they're closer to the batters, so they wear protective gear, right? They wear helmets with a face mask, And how fast do they whip that ball in? I mean, it's incredible.
Yeah.
It's fast pitch.
Yeah,
really.
It is. Yeah. So I think that on average, it's like 70-ish miles an hour that it comes in. But they're closer, there's all these studies that say it actually comes across home quicker than like over 100 miles an hour.
They have less reaction time to swing.
Yep, exactly.
Yeah.
So it's pretty impressive. And it's a cool game to watch. It's much quicker and fast paced than baseball is. So.
Is there any chance this could become professional again?
Softball, this team here? Yeah, there are professional softball teams or softball leagues out there. There's a couple out there. There's two that are the most well known. But we have just signed a player who has a potential of getting drafted one of these leagues. So it's one of those things where it's like, it's out there. It's just not super big right now.
So what was the name of the team that you've chosen this time around for?
For the name?
Yeah.
April 20th. Come on out.
What was the name?
She can't.
You think I'm going to trip up?
You're trying to trick her into giving the name out.
You're the first person to ask me. Everywhere I go, people are asking me.
So let's just review. April 20th is the big event at the Orpheum.
Big event at the Orpheum.
What time is that?
5 o'clock is doors. 5:30 is the start of the actual unveil.
And you'll have all kinds of activities going on.
It's free, family friendly, face painters and temporary tattoos and carnival games and all the things.
Excellent. Mm-hmm. Super.
Very good.
And you have a film presentation, I would assume.
Mm-hmm. Video.
Yeah. Yep.
Okay.
Yep.
And the logo.
Yep.
Okay. Logo. What does that logo look like?
You know, I wish I could tell you.
You don't know.
Have
you seen it?
I do. I have. I know what the logo looks like.
Yes.
Okay.
It's some sort of animal, but all the names are animals.
Okay. What are the four names again? What is it down to?
It's the Lake Munsters, Munster Cheese, the Swamp Angels, the Thunder Chickens, and the Nightmares.
Okay. All right. Well, Sam Rubin, thank you for coming in.
Yeah, thanks for having me.
General Manager of the Madison Mallards. Hope you have a great season with the Mallards that new team yet
to be named. Hopefully we'll see you in April.
All right.
All right.
Sounds good. Yeah. Baseball.
What was that name again?
Softball.
What was the first letter of
Give
the
name? Give it up. Peterson.
M for Madison.
Good answer.
Yes, Madison.
Thank you, Sam.
All right. Yeah, thanks
have
for having me.
Have a great season. Come back sometime, all right?
Yeah, thank you.
It is coming up on 19 past the hour. John and Gordy continue after these messages.
Driving to downtown today about a midnight hour.
This is the trip for our word of the hour. That's right. The key word is trip. T-R-I-P. I had somebody, I saw a text, somebody thought it was something similar to that.
It's a very heavy trip.
It's a trip. T-R-I-P.
Not trick.
No. trip. That's trip. The key word for our Ride into Spring contest. And again, we'll have different keywords throughout the day at 10 o'clock, also 1 o'clock and 3 o'clock. Mm-hmm. So you can continue to enter on any of our Civic Media stations on the Civic Media app. And it is a statewide contest, and we encourage you to enter. You could win a trip for Chula Vista, an overnight trip to Wisconsin Dells. And also, we have many grand prizes. We've got some bikes to give away, also patio furniture, 3-in-1 blender. So enter the contest. Again, the key word is trip.
Trip.
With a P. T-R-I-P. Okay?
Okay.
All right.
All right. We got it. All right. All right. Now, you know, The Guardian is a global news network.
Yes, it is.
I even gave them a little money the other day because I've been reading their stories for a long time. I thought, and they kind of reminded me of it.
Yeah.
See, they gave me a number of how many articles I've read. I thought, okay. Yeah. All right.
You want to donate.
A little donation here. Doesn't hurt. Okay. All right. Anyway, The Guardian has been doing amazing coverage of Wisconsin.
Yes, they have.
I don't even know why. Well, they must have somebody here that is interested in the election and what's going on politically here.
Well, because
it's a super gerrymandered state.
Yeah.
So obviously all the crazy things are happening in the Midwest in our state. Illinois is not like that. Minnesota's not like that. Michigan is no longer like that.
Mm.
It's just Wisconsin. Makes us very unique, doesn't it?
Anyway, swing state.
They wrote just a few days ago. It was March 20, 2016.
Okay, this was in The Guardian.
Yep. Wisconsin's Republican primary was just days away, and the GOP establishment was making a desperate last attempt to block Donald Trump from the Republican nomination. That's right. Mm-hmm. Wisconsin Republicans did not want Donald Trump. All the right-wingers, all of the announcers in the right-wing stations were anti-Trump.
Mm-hmm.
They supported Ted Cruz.
Yeah.
All right?
Mm-hmm.
And now they're solidly on board with Trump. So what happened, right? And that's, of course, latching onto the supposed stolen election myth and fake electors scheme, which they fell for hook, line, and sinker.
Mm-hmm.
I think it's a traumatic thing. They were traumatized by the entire idea of Trump being a president. It's like 9/11. And then people's brains twist just a little bit because of what's happening in reality, and they become super cultists.
Yeah, a traumatic event is what happened.
That's basically how it takes place, I think, anyway.
So what else did The Guardian have to say about
all
this?
So they wrapped up the article with this tip,
and
a hat tip, by the way, to Civic Media.
Yeah.
Yeah, the radio landscape of Wisconsin could be shifting. In 2022, the tech entrepreneur and Democratic Party donor Sage Weil introduced Civic Media, a left-leaning Wisconsin-based radio network, which he envisioned as a counterpoint to the right-wing voices that dominate the air.
Mm-hmm.
Not bad, huh?
Yeah.
I like that.
Yeah.
Michael Wagner, a professor of journalism and mass communications at the University of Wisconsin-Madison, said, there's some evidence that they're picking up some traction.
Mm-hmm.
So there you go. There's another station, of course, in Milwaukee that has taken a few of our talent already. So they're plucking away some of that. I guess that happens, you know, big station out there in Milwaukee. But it's nice to know that they're at least aware of us.
Yeah, we're on the radar there.
Yeah, we're on the radar finally.
Yeah, thanks to Guardian for those kind words.
Pretty cool, huh?
Excellent. Yeah, we're doing something right.
We're doing something right. Do it live.
We're doing our part here on the John and Gordy Show.
Well, I tell you what, it's time once again for another reminder of the mega say the darndest things.
Oh, more?
Yes.
They just don't stop. As long as they keep talking, we've got material.
Let me just tell you this. This is the weird thing, okay? I actually thought I could do this in one show.
We've gone through 3 or 4 shows now.
Yes, exactly. And I'm still drawing this thing out.
Okay. Yeah, megas say the darndest things.
Okay, well, here's somebody that texted us. I think John is wrong.
What?
Okay. It's not because of trauma. It's because they have been telling themselves for decades that the Democrats are evil, and that's probably true.
Mm-hmm.
It's probably true, too. I mean, you could add that to it. I don't think I'm wrong. I would add that.
And this texter also added, if your opponent is evil, then anyone who can win against evil is good. Okay.
That's right. Yep. Right. Good point.
The enemy of my enemy is my friend.
There you go.
Thank you, Sam.
All right. Should we hear some of the darndest things that the megas have been able to say recently?
Yes.
Next cut, right?
We're looking at 543.
Yes.
Yep. Dial it up.
Right down the list.
Okay.
All right.
Hit it.
They went after Richard Nixon. They went after Bill Clinton. And now the courts in several different states are finding different things about Trump. Is there anything that could happen with him indictment-wise that would say, all right, maybe this disqualifies him for president?
Not for me. I'm with him to the finish.
All right. Thank you so much.
He could stand on the front steps of the White House and commit murder, and I'm with him.
Explain that to me. That's amazing. I mean,
he's the only man we've ever had in my lifetime that stood for America as president. They don't anybody compare to Donald Trump. He loves this country, and that's why I love him. And nobody stood under the attack that Trump stood under.
Oh, yeah.
And look what he's done. He's hanging in there. He's for us. He loves this country.
Say one nice thing about Joe Biden to me.
I can't.
Right, so you just don't like Biden.
Oh, because I've looked at Biden when he was, he's just totally corrupt. How can you look beyond the corruption to say that this man could be a statesman for representing the United States? You know, the whole issue of his getting the millions of dollars with Hunter Biden, the media didn't cover that at all. Why? Why didn't they cover that?
So we were stronger when President Obama was in office?
No.
That was 10 years ago.
No, yeah. Obama started this whole mess and started dividing us. When Trump came in, he started getting us back to our roots, back to
white
loving
roots.
America,
yeah.
Back to helping get rid of the regulations so we could be more energy efficient. Now, look at, we're buying our oil from where? A foreign country, when we have enough here in this country to take care of us plus many?
Well, we've always bought our oil from other countries.
No, but we could produce more here.
Oh, yes. Okay, there you go. Isn't that something? So you like a candidate. I get that.
Right.
You're a big fan of theirs.
Mm-hmm.
But how can you think like that? Where is the thought process in coming up with those kinds of conclusions?
And the fact that one guy says he could stand on the front steps of the White House and murder somebody, and I'd be right there with him.
Woo.
Well, wow.
Yeah, I suppose when you have a draw like that, you can say almost anything and get away with it.
Yeah, Southern drawl helps.
Yeah, it does.
Now,
I've never been able to do that.
I know what you mean. All right.
Chewing on a straw.
a piece of chaw.
There you go.
Chaw. Okay.
We got more cuts, by the way, coming
up. Do we?
Yeah.
Okay.
And one of the great classic cuts ever,
mm-hmm.
It is A Woman Who Screams. And we'll be getting to that.
No.
Oh, I just can't wait for this one.
Okay, 7:29, we've got news and weather and Pam Yonke with the Farm Report. We're coming back with, oh boy, Shades of Reefer Madness for the Dangers of Social Media. Coming up.
Yes.
One person is in the hospital.
Yeah.
One.
Wow. That'll be an interview.
Well, think of how long they must have been in there before anybody can get out there.
Yeah.
Jeez.
Okay, where am I on this thing? Reefer Madness.
Oh, I didn't. Danger of Social Media, wake up, cut 347?
Yeah. That's going to be the wake-up thing.
Transgender space camp counselor. Yeah, I wondered if we had done that story.
Reefer Man.
I'm going to mention the keyword again.
Yep.
These people are proving the GOP is the party is stupid. The stupid thought process is they're stupid people. That's all 2227.
Yeah.
That's the same birth.
That's it. Yes. Now look, they're doing it slow mo.
Oh no.
That ship hit it directly head on.
It lost navigation, apparently. I mean, it just. You can't, They must have lost all power or something, and it was just drifting.
They hit it head on, though.
Yeah, that baby is, you know, it's like, yeah, you know, not in the center, but it's.
Is that the ship hitting it?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Wow. Yeah.
That's a huge
bridge.
Though.
Yeah.
Yeah. And the supports are basically beams, right? It's not even cement. It's just.
Well, I think they're. They're beams and cement, but I mean, they're anchored to cement.
Yeah,
in the water. Below, in the water.
Yeah, yeah, but if you hit the top, you know, it's like you know,
right,
like Lincoln logs,
right? Know? Yeah,
or erector set. Johnny erector set.
Do they still make erector sets?
I don't know. Did they?
Yeah, I played with them when I was a kid.
Really? Seem unsafe now. could choke on the parts.
Johnny erector set.
What is that guy? What's the guy in the yellow doing out there? He's cleaning up leaves off of a lamppost with a bucket.
Well, it's something that I didn't notice. I'm glad he took care of it, whatever it was.
Yeah, that's a leaf. He picked it off.
It's beautiful, oh, isn't it?
I got time to get coffee.
Gorgeous. It's gorgeous. I love that.
We haven't saluted coffee lately.
Coffee.
That's the coffee guy.
Coffee. We got to get the backward coffee guy out there, you know?
What are we doing? Which one?
Shades of Reefer Madness. The social media danger. Radio WMDX 92.7 FM 1580 AM, the John and Gordy Show, and we're sitting here on a very rainy day, looking out on a wet, soaked street, State Street. It's beautiful, isn't it?
Do
we have that cam all set up and ready to take a look out there viewing on Facebook?
Yeah, or YouTube. Yeah, there's some traffic moving through downtown this morning.
That's right.
It looks like the rain has let up at least for the moment, but. Expecting more showers off and on today and falling temperatures, 49 degrees to start, and we'll be down into the upper 30s later on. Want to remind everybody what the key word is as we're in a key word hour here during 7 o'clock. You have to keyword. You have up until 8 o'clock to get the keyword into your text on the Civic Media app to enter our contest, the Ride Into Spring contest. You could win a overnight stay at Chula Vista in Wisconsin Dells, and you'll also be entered to win one of two grand prizes that include new bikes, also outdoor patio furniture, a 3-in-1 blender, and more. And this is a statewide contest. Again, the word for this hour, the keyword is trip, T-R-I-P. Yeah. P as in Peter, trip, okay? Trip.
Yep.
That's the keyword.
I'm on a trip here. Let's let's say a little update.
Is it a good trip?
Two people saved from the water after the ship or the tanker hit a bridge support for the Baltimore Bridge, the Key Bridge. And that collapsed completely. You probably see the video today, probably all day long in regards to that. And they're still looking for people. The other big thing that's going on is the Supreme Court case dealing with the the abortion pill. I can't remember what the name of the pill is, but they're going to be talking about that, and there's going to be analysis later on from all the pundits later on this evening.
Yeah,
trying to analyze what it looked like the decision might end up being. I mean, this is a drug that's been out there for 40 years already and kind of proven itself over time. But for some reason, they're going to dissect this. And it could have major implications in regards to the FDA drug approval process. And that's one of the things that they're looking at. And hopefully, this is going to be an okay decision. They're going to say, well, it's been around along. It's proven itself over time. So, you know, we're going to leave things well enough alone.
Yeah, the FDA first approved it's mifepristone, I believe.
Mifepristone.
Prestone, okay. So they approved it in 2000. Good. So it's been around since, 24 years.
Well, it was in Europe.
Yeah, for
it was
a long
Europe
time before
that.
Yes.
Yeah, so this is the headline is Supreme Court will now have to deal with consequences of its Roe v. Wade ruling. This is another one of those crazy rulings that didn't make any sense at all. 50 years of Supreme Court justices approving this particular ruling, and then all of a sudden these guys come in, and they knew better. They knew better than all of the other previous justices, and they overturned it because it was something they dedicated themselves to do. Mm-hmm. The Federalist Society
decided this
is what they wanted to do, and they did it.
Yep.
Willy-nilly, and now we're suffering the consequences.
Yeah, according to the FDA, more than 5 million women have taken the drug, mifepristone, since it became available or was approved back in 2000.
Right.
5 million.
I know. It's just it's just insane to question whether we should have it on the market or not.
Yeah.
It's just ridiculous.
Okay. Well, we'll watch that story today from the Supreme Court.
Yep. Here's a story that no one's watching, but it's a big deal. It is really a big deal. I just can't believe this. Governor DeSantis in Florida signed a bill that bans children younger than 14 years from holding social media accounts. It also requires 14 to 15-year-olds how to obtain parental approval to hold accounts on social media that employ algorithms that have certain addictive features. Wow, really? The parents are going to know this? and anybody, are they all going to know this? Every one of these social media websites basically have algorithms.
Right.
So it kind of bans everything. Now, how do you... So how do you put it back in the bottle?
You can't.
All these kids already have these accounts. How do you put that back in the bottle?
I don't see any way.
I don't see how this is.
It doesn't happen.
This is even possible. According to the Florida House Speaker, the internet has become a dark alley for children where predators target them. And dangerous social media leads to higher rates of depression, self-harm, and even suicide. Wow.
Well, what can be done? I compare
this to Reefer Madness. Because this is the same kind of crap we heard with Reefer Madness, how dangerous it was. I was going to turn people into rapists. Yeah. No. And this now is going, it's this dark alley. Mm-hmm. I never heard that analogy before. But here we are. Depression, self-harm, suicide. Well, you could, you know, say anything causes that, right? Just life itself, or living in Florida would create that situation.
Do younger generations know about the movie Reefer Madness, do you think? Do they catch the reference?
I don't know.
Yeah, because it was made in the 30s or 40s, right?
Yeah, something like that.
Yeah, and it was all about the dangers of marijuana, and it was all just over the top. Crazy,
right?
The whole movie.
They would smoke pot and become crazy, insane. Yeah. That insane, crazy look on their face, and they'd, you know, be playing the piano crazily, attacking women crazily.
Yeah,
you know, just ridiculous.
Reefer
stuff.
Madness.
In fact, we should ask Sam.
Yeah. Do you remember the movie Reefer Madness? Are you familiar?
I'm familiar with it. Okay. I've watched part of it before.
Yeah. Okay.
It's a really goofy, stupid movie.
Yes, it is. Yes.
And now the same thing is happening for social media.
Yeah.
And we're doing the same thing, and we're going to look back on it and think, what the hell? Why did we even listen to these people? But it's happening in Florida. 14 and younger cannot have social media accounts, but they already do. I just can't wrap my head around anything that goes on in Florida.
Let's get to the John and Gordy hotline. Joe is on the phone this morning with a comment. Wow. Good morning, Joe.
Hi, Joe.
Hey, guys. I was really intrigued and interested in the array of Trump voters, their thoughts on Trump and kind of what propels their allegiance. And it was a fascinating bit. And I think it's something you can return to. One of the things that struck me while you were playing it is a friend of mine who is her field of study is rhetoric, you know, the argumentation and debate. How do you make an argument? And one of the things she said is if people come across with a statement like, well, Biden is totally corrupt, the one rejoinder to that is, what's your evidence? You know, do you have any evidence?
Yes,
can you bring up, you know, anything at all to sort of say that? And it's, you know, and I try to use that in my own to think, okay, I think that Biden's a good president. So what's my evidence of it? My evidence is, you know, unemployment has been going down hugely. I mean, the largest increase in jobs ever. And one can certainly argue the evidence would certainly be that the Inflation Reduction Act and the CHIPS Act that he was able to get through really propelled a big increase in jobs. And in addition, you know, he's not the kind of guy that refers to the military, as Trump did, as losers and suckers.
Yes.
So, I that's another piece of evidence. So it's just interesting. There was a woman in your array who spoke of, well, the Bidens are totally corrupt. Well, what's your evidence? Particularly because you said earlier in the hour you had evidence that Swalwell had as to why the impeachment against Biden was going absolutely nowhere, you
exactly.
know, with being deep six. Because, geez, if you had the votes, you'd go for it. You know, geez, if your witness wasn't in prison right now because of your chief witness wasn't in prison, you might go for it. And, geez, didn't we just have that Lev Parnas appearing before Congress and saying, it was just all a ruse. It was garbage I was being fed by the Russians, and you all picked up on it. So it's useful, I think, sometimes just to sort of say the simple sentence, what's your evidence?
Exactly.
You know, it's just rather than your gut feelings of he just fills my heart with love. Okay, what's your evidence? You know
exactly.
what I mean?
That's a very good point. And I've got a new thing that I'm latching on to.
Yeah.
I'm gonna debut it right now with you, Joe, and Gordy.
Yeah,
I just want to bring this up. This is big. This is it occurred to me last night, and now I'm going to bring it up often, I think. What's happening in Michigan is that Trump has asked canvassers to go out and look for black voters. Okay.
All right.
Now I'm thinking to myself, wait a minute here. They want to get rid of DEI because they don't see color anymore. They see character. And I'm thinking, wait, if you're going after black voters, how can you do it? What is this? What happened to the character part of it? Whatever happened to that?
Black is a color.
I think they see color. It's just a shot. I'm taking a guess here. Stepping out on a limb. Yeah. And that's going to be my debate from now on, because I read a story here in Wisconsin, a black student had to move to another community, a much friendlier, more diverse community, because he was basically chased out and harassed in the community he was in. And again, is it because of his character or color? Mm-hmm. Right. And we're getting rid of DEI a little early here. I think we're jumping the gun.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah, let's keep having examples of that. That's just sad, but instructive.
All right.
Very, very instructive.
All right.
Thanks, guys.
Thanks, Joe.
All right, Joe.
Appreciate the call and allowing me to rant as well. I never do.
No, no, you don't.
I sit here silently, like a lump on a chair. Sorry about that, Gordy. Oh,
taking my position away from you.
I know.
Okay.
Should we talk about your little... when we were scripting,
I don't think we can describe it.
I was gonna mention it, but yeah, I don't know if
I don't know if
people would understand just how funny it is without seeing
it.
Yeah, I know.
It's a little behind the scenes stuff.
It is behind the scenes.
We have our planning document every day on the show.
It's an outline.
Yeah. It's an outline.
And
some of the things
the
that we're gonna talk about. I mean, we rarely refer to it once we start.
Well,
it kind of goes out the window sometimes.
We kind of push a lot of the subject matter down the list until we can't get to it. And then on Friday, we hit, Dumpster.
Dumpster Fire Friday.
Dumpster
is
Fire
Friday
is this Friday, last Friday of the month. Yeah. Oh, by the way, tomorrow we'll be at Short Stack Eatery.
Oh, yes.
At 301 West Johnson, so we invite you to join us.
Oh, were you
six
know.
To 8.
We're down there.
Always a good time at Short Stack.
Yeah.
So, hope you can show up. So we were just discussing something before the show. Back to our little discussion behind the scenes.
Yeah.
I just made a couple of notes to show John, and I don't know what I'm not exactly sure what happened from there, but I had made some notes alongside some of the things that you were about to talk about, and I wrote on there, that's right. Oh, really? Tell me more. Yeah.
I know.
Like that.
Stuff to wedge,
like that stuff
wedge
I'm gonna contribute. And John found that humorous.
I
showed it to you right before you started talking.
I did. You have a larger part here than that.
Well, some days I do. Some days I don't. That's okay.
Oh, I can. I sense some anger there. Oh,
I'm just here for moral support and to keep the trains running on time.
That's right.
You know,
that's right. Because I never look at the clock.
You never look at the clock. You never look at the
it's never good.
The time signals that Sam is giving us. He signals me, and then I signal you, and you still ignore both of us after almost 6 months on the air.
Hey, we got a comment. Texters. I went through DEI training recently, and it was inoffensive and thought provoking. I came away feeling that if you find DEI troubling, you either have no personal experience with this training or you're a racist.
Mm-hmm.
You guys should get your hands on the training. It's good material. And that's what you would think.
Well, yes. You know, I work for Sauk County part-time, and we've gone through some of that training. Yeah, it is very thought-provoking, and it does make you think about everything
in that regard.
And there's nothing wrong with
it.
It's a very positive thing.
It's so typical because the megas basically want to go. They want to skip the difficult part of trying to weed out racism. They just want to go to the part where they go to character right away.
Mm-hmm.
Forget about the color.
Exactly, right. 7:49. Cloudy, rainy today, 49 degrees, and when we come back, this, that, the other, and some leftovers, but also Gen Z, they're still living at home?
Mm-hmm.
Is that right?
Mm-hmm.
I'll have that coming up.
I have proof.
Yeah. I don't know how to explain it, what happened yesterday.
Well, I have
you guys.
What?
No, you
did a good job.
Did I?
Yeah, it worked.
So, hey, turn the, can you turn our mics off for a second?
Thank you.
Radio, WMDX and 92.7 FM and 1580 on your AM dial. By the way, you can also check us out on social media. We're on those platforms live. You can even see us.
I guess.
Does it matter?
Yeah. Facebook, YouTube, X. I think we're on Twitter, X.
We had so many plans for the video version of this show. Didn't we?
You know, we still have plans.
We're kind of from television. You know, we had our cable access show, one of the most popular cable access shows in the country. And we had our late night movie show. Prove us wrong. Look it up, folks.
That was 30 years ago. I'm sure you remember it like it was yesterday.
The cable access ratings, you know, they're always posted.
I don't think cable access even exists anymore. I'm pretty sure that's...
No, I think it's gone.
Yeah.
I think it's gone now.
A long time ago.
But we had our late night movie show.
Yeah, right.
Right?
Yeah.
Just kind of winged our
way through. Really, really late at night after midnight when nobody was watching.
No, no. Everybody was watching that.
Yeah.
At least in my mind.
In your mind. Yeah. That was a long time ago. But, you know, this is John and Gordy 2.0. Is that what you're
That's exactly right. And and here we are in video. Everything is now in social media.
You know,
you have to have video with it. So here we are, and we wanted to do something fancy schmancy with this thing. We want to add special effects.
Don't get too technical. You know, we didn't work together for 29 years.
Yeah.
You know, but here we are, and we've been here at Civic Media now for 5 or 6 months. And, you know, it's just like riding a bicycle.
It is.
An old, rusty, out-of-date bicycle.
How do we keep the news media away from us? You want to cover this story. It's an incredible story. That, you know, thinking, oh, my God, these guys are back after so many years.
These guys,
But, you know, we're keeping them at bay.
I think it's more like those guys. Yeah. Anyway, one more time, I want to remind everybody before the 8 o'clock hour rolls around, you still have a few minutes to text in this hour's keyword. If you're in on the contest, the Ride Into Spring Text to Win contest, statewide contest here on Civic Media. The keyword is trip. So you use your Civic Media app and put in the word trip, and you're in the contest. You could win an overnight stay at Chula Vista or one of many other grand prizes. Okay? All right.
All right. Now, I've talked about Gen Z quite a bit on this program. I'd like to more or less say 20-somethings, 30-somethings, but, you know, it's
Gen Z.
Coded now. Gen Z. All right. Got a couple of them. In my house.
In the basement.
Yeah, gamers doing their thing.
Do they come out of the basement once in a while?
Yes, they do.
Okay.
One works part-time video production, and the other one is producing a game, a board game, Dungeons and Dragons type of game. All created it with his friends, and they're putting that together.
Well, that's good.
So they're going to eventually market that, I would assume. But they're at home. And I thought maybe, you know, people would say, why? You should be kicking them out, you know, encouraging them to leave. Mm-hmm. And I'm finding out that almost everybody I talk to has a Gen Zer at home.
Mm-hmm.
So it's not unusual. It's not strange. And, and it's typical. And by the way, there's a reason for it. With younger generation facing tough economic circumstances, many parents are supporting their children long past the college years. Nearly half of young adults in the U.S. live at home. Nearly half.
Wow. That's a stunning figure right there.
Yeah. And millions more are receiving help with their rent, bills, and everyday costs.
Mm-hmm.
For parents, it's a major expense, sometimes requiring greater debt loads, depleted savings, and delayed retirement plans.
Mm-hmm.
And I tell you what, that last line?
Delayed retirement plans. Yeah. We're both working.
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah.
So that line stood out for me. I want my kids to see it. I'm depleting my retirement funds. Now, when you get your job, you're going to have to help me, right?
That's the way it's supposed to work, yes.
The percentage of young adults living with their parents is roughly on a par with the 1940s, believe it or not.
Mm-hmm.
But the uptick now is being driven in part by how the pandemic normalized living with parents. It's also gotten harder to find good entry-level jobs and afford a higher cost of living.
Mm-hmm.
The pandemic put the whole business of growing up on a different timetable than in the past, said clinical technician blah 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 blah, author of Failure to Launch While You're 20s, 30s.
I'm sorry. Blah, 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 you know blah. Where does he, is he a professor?
You know.
Source that again for us.
Okay, well, this is the thing with me. I
you're not making this up, are you?
No. No.
Okay. No, but it's blah 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 blah. I never heard you reference that guy before.
Okay, this is kind of a pet peeve of mine because I listen to people, you know, read these stories on the air,
right.
and they always mess up the person's name.
Well, that's
and
true.
I'm so done with that because I don't care. I don't remember the name after that. It's not a big deal.
Okay.
So that.
Okay. Well, all right.
And plus, I'm making the stuff up.
Okay. No. The truth comes out.
Not really. Okay. Anyway, right. The author of the book, Why Your 20-something Hasn't Grown Up and What to Do About It.
Yeah, what to do about it.
Yeah.
What can you do about
it? U.S. parents spend about $500 billion every year on their 18 to 34-year-old children, which is double what they put towards their retirement.
Oh, but 500 billion?
Billion, yes. Yes, cumulative.
Lord.
It's not something I make myself. Well,
what else did blah, 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 blah have to say? Okay.
Okay.
Yeah. are we still on the air? Okay.
Yeah. Sometimes helping your kids now is an investment in your future so they can help you later on.
Oh, hey, look who just showed up.
What the hell is wrong with you? Have you lost your mind?
Yes, he has.
Both
me?
Of you.
Oh,
you're just
me?
Nothing
me?
But, I've been walking here for 10 minutes. I'm hearing nothing but laughter.
Well,
we can blame Professor blah, 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 blah for that. Him and his new book.
We were talking about Sam's movie, so I was wrong with my little snotty text. So I want to just say
that. Oh, okay.
But that's okay.
Okay.
People have forgotten it.
That's okay.
People have forgotten about that. You haven't. I can see it in your eyes.
Okay.
People call us idiots all the time. So.
That's right. We're used to that.
Yes.
Okay.
We roll with those punches.
All right.
Anyway, the act of moving in with parents is seen as a pragmatic way to get ahead, and most agree younger generations are navigating a broken. Are we off the air yet?
Okay. We got 30 seconds.
Maybe
John.
For the last time.
I'm just ending it. You know that they're living at home. You know.
Thank you for that.
You know.
Yeah, okay. That's going to do it for the John and Gordy Show for this Tuesday. We hope you have a wonderful day. We'll be back at Short Stack Eatery tomorrow morning, 6 to 8 a.m. We hope you'll join us then.
Yes.
You and us and
everyone
blah, blah, blah.
And blah, blah, blah. We'll make it.
Okay.
This is a great interview, by the way.
John and Gordy Show.